What's up guys, Sal here. So 2019 is an interesting year for Huawei. They were doing really good in the first half of the year, but they found themselves at the center of a global tussle between the US and China, limiting the business US companies could do with it and leading to Google blocking Huawei's future access to Google apps and services. In the face of all of these setbacks, they decided to launch the Mate 30 Pro lineup without Google Apps and Play Store. The lack of Google services seriously limited the Mate 30 Pro's range appeal to Western customers. As a result of this, Huawei launched the Mate 30 Pro exclusively for China. Now, it's looking like Huawei will not get the access to Google Apps anytime soon, which means their future phones, including the flagship Huawei P40 Pro, look set to follow in the footsteps of the Mate 30 Pro, meaning they won't have access to Google Apps and services either. That really sucks because these are really good phones, but what can you do? Of course, with that being said, rumors about the P40 Pro are swirling on the internet for the past few days, suggesting Huawei could do something revolutionary with the P40 Pro lineup. In particular, rumors are saying the P40 Pro will have a 5500 mAh graphene battery. But before you get too excited, let me tell you, it's a total BS in my opinion. First of all, these rumors originated from this guy, who also shared the full specifications of the handset. Some of them make sense, some of them don't. He has literally no track record. It's highly unlikely to get the full specifications of a high-profile device 3 months well in advance. So my advice is to not believe these rumors. It's totally baseless, and the graphene batteries are not even ready to be commercialized yet. Samsung is making the graphene batteries for smartphones. Considering the revolutionary aspect of it, I don't think they would let their arch rival Huawei use it first before using it on their own device. So don't believe this guy. I wasn't gonna actually talk about this considering how stupid this is, but a lot of big publications were covering it, and a lot of you were asking me whether or not the rumors are true, so I had to make a video. The bottom line is, these specs are totally baseless, so don't believe it. Huawei makes its own processor for its smartphones. The current one is the Kirin 990, which appeared on the Mate 30 Pro and will appear inside the P40 Pro as well. It's based on the 7nm process. Now, we already have information about their next processor, the Kirin 1020. It's codenamed Baltimore, and it will appear on the Mate 40 Pro, which will launch in the second half of 2020. It will be a 5nm processor. The lower the number, the more transistors fit inside a chip, bringing improved performance and more energy efficiency. It's been reported that the Kirin 1020 will offer a 50% performance boost compared to the Kirin 990. The interesting thing that you might not be aware of is that Huawei used Cortex A76 for the Kirin 990 instead of the A77. Their CEO said A77 uses more battery, and people don't really need that much of speed, which is weird because ARM says the A77 provides a 20% performance boost with no additional draw on the battery. Anyway, the good news is Huawei will directly jump to Cortex A78 cores for the Kirin 1020. Apple, by the way, is going to be the first one to use the 5nm chipset on the iPhone 12. These are made by TSMC and will offer a significant performance boost compared to the 7nm processors. Of course, that being said, do consider subscribing for all the latest smartphone tech news. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.